A very good morning to you all students. I welcome you all to the chemistry online class. In this video, we are going to discuss about the lesson solution. Before entering into the lesson solution, we have to learn about mixtures. It is not a new term for you. Already in grade 9, you studied at mixtures. In day-to-day our life, the most of the things that we are using is in the form of mixtures. So what is mixture? Mixture is a It consists of two or more substances. And the substance that present in the mixtures can be of more than one physical state. That is, solid in liquid, solid in solid, or solid in gas. Similarly, liquid in solid at any composition and at any physical state. We know that mixture is broadly classified into two categories. Do you remember? What are the two classifications? Yes, it is homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. We know that the substance that present in the mixture, that is the components, can be separated easily, whereas in some cases, it cannot be separated. For example, we can consider two mixtures. In first example, we can take common salt, that is sodium chloride, dissolved in water. And in another glass tube, we can take water with the sand. So here we have taken two different types of mixtures which contains two components. In one, salt in water, the other one, sand in water. What the difference you can see in both the glass? What is one of the components in both the mixtures? Am I right? So it acts as a solvent in both. Where in first two case, the salt that is solute that we have taken completely dissolves in water. After that, you cannot differentiate salt and water separately, and physically you cannot separate salt from water. Whereas in the second example, sand in water, it can be separated by the technique filtration, but salt cannot be separated as it dissolves in the water uniformly. So from these two examples, we come to know that homogeneous means the solid particles uniformly distributed throughout the solvent. In heterogeneous mixtures, the solid particles, they are not uniformly distributed. And homogeneous mixture, it shows single phase. That is, after dissolving salt in water, it exists as a single solution, that is a salt solution. Whereas in sand and water, it shows boundaries between sand and water, and it shows two phases. And in the first example, that is salt in water, whereas salt completely dissolves uniformly throughout the solvent, and it exists in homogeneous mixture. This kind of homogeneous mixture, where has uniform distribution of solid particle solvent, is termed as solution. Now we understood what is solution. So two kinds of mixtures are there, homo and hetero. In homogeneous, the particles are uniformly distributed everywhere, and such kind of solution or such kind of mixture, that is the such kind of homogeneous mixture, is called as solution. So day to day our life, we are using what? Most of the things in the form of solution. The best example, seawater is a solution. It's a mixture of many dissolved salts. The next best example is air. Air is a mixture of different gases, that is nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, and other. But they are uniformly distributed everywhere as a homogeneous mixture. The other examples that we are using in our day-to-life activities is, see, drinks that we have most in the form of solution. Fruit juice, aerated drinks, tea, coffee, etc. are all in the form of solution. Now we can see what is the definition for. From this you understood, isn't it? What is the definition for solution? Solution is a homogeneous mixture of two or more substances. Okay, students? So what is solution? The solution is a homogeneous mixture. That means homogeneous mixture, it consists of two or more substances that are uniformly distributed. The next important term that you have to learn is solute and solvent. Don't think that solvent means it means only the liquid, that is water. No, it's not like that. see, we can see the definition for solute. The component in a solution, the component present in lesser amount by weight is called as solute. For example, we have studied now two exams, am I right? The first example, we have taken salt in water, 1 cup of water and 1 tablespoon of salt. 1 tablespoon, it has what? Lesser amount by weight, isn't it? It's less amount by weight. So it is called a solute, whereas the water, it is larger amount by weight. Then it is called a solvent. Similarly, alloys, see alloys, gold alloy, 80% you are taking gold and 20% if you are adding copper means this 80% is a higher concentration, isn't it? It's a larger amount by weight, hence it is called a solvent. And the remaining percentage or 2%, the remaining percentage that is lesser amount by weight, then it is called a solid. So solvent as well as solid may be of any physical state, that is solid, liquid or gas. So it means, that means solute means solid and water means solvent. Don't think like that. Solid can be also solid, liquid, gas, and solvent can be also solid, liquid and gas. Only based on the weight, the amount, the larger amount and the lesser amount by weight only, we are differentiating solute and solvent. The dissolution, that is the solute, gets distributed uniformly throughout the solvent and forms a homogeneous mixture. And this process of dissolution, this process of dissolving in the solvent uniformly, and this process is called as dissolution. Clear, students? First, we studied about solution. It's a homogeneous mixture. Mixture means we know that it consists of two or more substances uniformly distributed. The next important term we studied, solute and solid. Lesser amount, the substance that present in the lesser amount in a solution is called as solute, and larger amount by weight is called as solid. Similarly, the process of dissolving solute completely and uniformly in the solvent, and this process is called as dissolution. This process is called as dissolution. So from this you understood that solute plus solvent forms solution. Solute plus solvent. A solution must contain a solute and solvent. The next important terms we are going to learn is what is called as binary solution and what is called as ternary solution. In the definition itself we studied, a solution is a combination of two or more substances. If it consists of at least two components, then we call it as binary solution. For example, salt in water, one solute, one solvent. So two components forms a solution, then it is called as binary solution. Okay, that is, it must have one solute and one solvent, which forms a binary solution. For example, salt in water, sugar in water, and copper sulfate in crystals in water. Similarly, if it contains more than two components, that may be two solute and one solid, both the solids are dissolved in one solvent, means it totally consists of how many components? Three components, and the solution is named as ternary solution. So solution can be of binary as well as more than two components, means a ternary solution. Then we are going to learn about types of solutions. The first one is the classification based on the physical state of the solute and solvent. What are the three physical states? Solid, liquid and solvent. Based on the physical state of the solute and solvent, we can classify the solution. So already I said, a solute and solvent can be of any of its one of its physical state. So based on that, it is classified into first solid, solid in solid, that is both solute as well as solvent can be both in solid state. Best example is alloys, then liquid in solid, mercury with sodium, as well as liquid in gas. The next one is liquid solution. Here solute is solid, where a solvent is liquid. Here solid can be of solid, liquid and gas. Similarly of gaseous solutions. So this table is very important for the one word. So this is the classification based on physical state of solute and solvent. Okay, so solvent may be of solid liquid gas. Similarly, solid also may be of solid liquid or gas. Based on the concentration, it forms a solid solution or liquid solution or gaseous solution. The next one is based on the type of solvent. So what is solvent? Which is present in lesser amount, which is the component present in larger amount by which is called a solvent. Most of the substances are soluble in water. See, most of the we will use water as the solvent for dissolving the solute. Water is called as the universal solvent, okay, because most of the things that gets dissolved in water. But some substances are there which does not dissolve in water, therefore we will choose the other substances are benzene, alcohol, ether, etc. Okay, so mostly most of the substances that dissolve in water, so water is called as universal, which does not dissolve in water. We can use some organic solvents, that is benzene, ether, etc. We know that polar compounds dissolve in polar solvents and non-polar compounds dissolve in non-polar solvents. So based on the solid particle, we will choose the solvent. Based on some, there are two types, aqueous and non-aqueous. So aqueous means we are using water as the solvent. Other than water, if you are using any liquid, that may be alcohol, benzene, ether or any organic substance, then we call that as a non-aqueous solution. So two types are there, students, aqueous solution and non-aqueous solution. Aqueous solutions, the solution in which water acts as solvents. So best example, common salt in water, sugar in water, copper sulfate in water. We know that ionic compounds soluble in water and form aqueous solution. Ionic compound means charged compounds which have positive and negative. We know that sodium chloride, Na plus Cl, Na positive, Cl negative, so they are neutral, isn't it? They are ionic compounds, when so they will dissolve easily in the water. Whereas the non-charged particles, the non-polar solutes, they will dissolve in non-polar solvents. So except water, we can use any other liquids for dissolving such type of solutes, then we will call that as non-aqueous solutions. Okay, other than water, any liquid, that may be a benzene, ether, alcohol, anything, if you are using for dissolving or dissolving substances, then we will call it as non-aqueous solution. So some of the examples I said, benzene, ether, alcohol. For best example, you can see carbon disulfide acetone, that is sulfur, it is a non-polar compound, hence it does not dissolve in water. So we are choosing carbon disulfide, which makes sulfur to get dissolved. Similarly, iodine, non-polar compound, that never dissolve in water, so we are choosing carbon tetrachloride. Other than water, if you are using such type of organic solvents, then we will call it as, this organic solvents, we will call it as non-aqueous solution. So based on the type of solvent, two, aqueous and non-aqueous. The next classification. So the first one, based on the what? Physical state of solute and solvent. Next one, based on the type of solvent. The third one is based on the amount of solute. The next one, what we are going to see is based on the amount of solute. Under this, three classifications are there. One is saturated, unsaturated and super saturated. First we can see what is the saturated solution. So for everything there is a saturation. Is it at a point? The point after that there will be no chemical reaction. That is called as equilibrium state, isn't it? In chemical reaction, when it reaches certain point, after that there will be no chemical reaction. But that is its saturation. So when you are hungry, you will meet more, isn't it? At one point of view, said it's enough, no more food. So your mouth is, stomach is saturated. After that, you cannot. Like that, the solvent that we are using for dissolving also has some saturation. It can also only dissolve particular amount of solute. That is the saturation. First one, in saturated solution, we can take 100 ml of water, 100 gram of water is equal to 100 ml of water. In this 100 ml of water, have the ability to dissolve only 36 gram of solute, that is sodium chloride. 100 ml of water can dissolve only 36 gram of sodium chloride. After that, it found undissolved. The point at which it found undissolved is called as saturation. 36, after when you are adding 1 more gram of salt to 100 gram of water, it found undissolved. So the saturation point of 100 ml of water for salt is 36 gram. So after that, no more solute can be dissolved. Isn't it? 100 ml of water can dissolve 36 gram of what? Salt. After that, no more solute can be added to the solvent because it found undissolved. So that is called as saturated solution. A solution in which no more solute can be added to the saturated solution. Unsaturated means, I said that 100 ml of water can dissolve 36 gram. But if you are dissolving only 10 gram, 20 gram, 30 gram means it is said to be unsaturated. If you are adding 30 gram of salt, again 6 more gram we can add it. So the solution is said to be unsaturated. After adding 36 gram, you will say it is saturated. So more solute can be added to the solvent since it is saturation. For example, if you are adding 36 gram means how many more grams of salt you can add again? 6 gram. So until it reaches 36 gram, the solution is said to be unsaturated. So what is unsaturated solution? It is a solution which contains less solute than its saturation point. Supersaturated means, I said that 100 can dissolve only 36. But when you are adding 44 gram and you are making it dissolve more solute than its saturated point, 100 can dissolve only 36. But we are adding more than 36, then such type of solution is called as supersaturated. By heating, for example, you are heating 100 ml of water, you're adding 40. So it can dissolve 40 gram. But after cooling, this extra 4 gram is found undissolved. Okay, so such type of solutions you can call it as unsaturated solution. So based on the amount of solute, this is the three classification, that is saturated solution, unsaturated solution and supersaturated solution. Okay, so three types of classification we have studied. Among that, aqueous, non-aqueous, very important for 2 marks. And this is saturated, unsaturated, it's a book bag question. The last type of classification is based on the concentrated and diluted solution. We know that concentrated, diluted solution. So, what's the difference between concentrated? Based on the concentrated means, see, when you taste the tea, if there is more sweet, you will say the amount of sugar is high. That we call strong tea, isn't it? Strong tea, isn't it? Taste is high. If the sweet is less, we will say it is a diluted. If you have more sweet, we will say it is concentrated. Like that, concentrated acid is there, diluted acid. Both have 100 ml, both we can take. First, for example, concentrated means the percentage of water will be less and acid will be more. Whereas diluted means the percentage of what? The percentage of concentrated salt acid is more, where diluted the concentration of water is more. So we will say it is a concentrated and diluted solution based on color and density. That only determines, okay, the difference between diluted and concentrated. From this diagram you can differentiate. See, diluted solution, the solute component is less, whereas in concentrated solution the solute component is more, isn't it? Whereas the solvent is similar, same quantity. Both have same quantity of water, but the quantity of solute in both is different. So there it may, which has less concentration may have less density and less color, which have more concentration may have high density and high color. Based on this, we will differentiate it is diluted and concentrated. Clear? So now we can, in this video, I have attached some question answers. Please mark it. First one is, define the term solution. What is mean by binary solution? What is aqueous and non-aqueous? That is short answer. 1, 2, 3 and 4 attached along this video, and also Roman number 7, the first question also attached here. Please mark it in the book and learn. Thank you.